Hello dear children, I am Anisha Reginald, Faculty of Science. Welcome to the section of EVS, 3rd Standard, 2nd Chapter, from Doodlebug to Tusker. Do you know what is a doodlebug? This is a picture of a doodlebug. And what is a tusker? Which animal is having long tusk, white color tusk? Yes, an elephant, isn't it? So these are the topics we are going to discuss for today. Wild animals, domestic animals and its uses, classification of animals, techniques of creatures that catches prey. Prey means its food. So, what are wild animals? Do you know what are wild animals? Who is the king of the jungle? Yes, lion, isn't it? Lion is the king of the jungle. Animals which lives in forest like lion, tiger, giraffe, elephant, fox, monkey, etc. are known as wild animals. Animals that live in jungles, forest or in nature and hunt their own food and water, they are called wild animals. Wild animals are dangerous and fierce. These are the examples of wild animals. Kangaroo, monkey, snake, zebra, panda and some birds also you can see here, ostrich, vulture, etc. These all are the examples of wild animals. Next, domestic animals. What are domestic animals? Domestic animals are also called farm animals. Domestic animals. Animals like cow, hen, sheep, goat, duck, which are useful to mankind. They are known as domestic animals. We keep these animals in our homes to particular needs. These are the pictures of domestic animals. Domestic animals are also known as farm animals. Cow, pig, deer, sheep, chicken, all these are some examples of domestic animals. The creatures that we keep in our homes for particular needs, that is for milk, for egg, for meat and as pets. So cow, goat, camel, these animals we kept in our homes for milk. For egg, hen, duck, turkey, etc. we keep in our homes for their eggs. For meat, hen, duck, cow, goat, camel, rabbit, these are some animals we keep in our home for their meat. Then comes as pets. Cat, dog, fish, parrot, squirrel, lovebirds. We keep it as pets for amusement and companionship. So these are about domestic animals. They are also called farm animals. Are you all vegetarian or non-vegetarian? Some people eat vegetarian food and some are non-vegetarian. Like that, on the basis of food habits, creatures are classified into herbivorous, carnivorous and omnivorous. So, what are herbivorous animals? Creatures that eat only plant food, they are called herbivorous. Examples, deer, rabbit, parrot, cow, sheep, etc. are herbivorous. Carnivorous, creatures that eat plant food and animal food or flesh eating animals are called carnivorous. Examples, lion, tiger, cheetah, fox, wolf, snake, etc. are carnivorous animals. Next comes omnivorous. Creatures that eat both plant food and flesh eating animals are called omnivorous. Examples are duck, hen, bear, crow, pig, squirrel. These all are omnivorous animals. Next topic is about techniques to catch prey. Prey means their food. How organisms catches its prey? Different techniques are used to catch its prey. So every organism seeks different techniques to catch its prey. Callats. How callats catches its prey? Using its sticky tongue. You can see in this picture, callats uses its sticky tongue to catch its prey. Then comes spider. spider formed a web to trap its prey. Then comes woodpecker. It pecks on tree with its strong beak. It split opens the tree bark. Inside the tree bark, the insects are there. It pecks with its strong beak. And it also has strong claws, very sharp nails. It fixes the woodpecker on the tree. This is how a woodpecker catches its prey. Then comes doodle bug. Doodle bug is also called ant lion. Do you know how doodle bugs catch its prey? This is a picture of a doodle bug and the pit made by the doodle bug. So it digs the pit in dry soil, areas that do not get direct sunlight or rain. You may have seen the pits in our verandas, the yard of our house. Some creatures that fall into that pit never climb out of this pit because it is very dry soil. So this is how doodle bug catches its prey. So next comes duck. How duck catches its prey? It has a flat beak. Using its flat beak, it searches food in mud and in water. It has a web-like feet. It helps to swim in water. And also, it can stand firmly in mud without sinking. So this is how a duck catches its prey. Hen, it scratches the ground with its feet and pecks the food with its beak. This is how hen catches its prey. Lion, tiger, cheetah, leopard, etc. It has sharp nails and teeth. With the help of this, it catches prey and tears it. This is how catches its prey. So dear children, I am giving an activity for today. Observe and write how lizard catches its prey. All of you do this activity. So I am going to wind up this class for now. Thank you so much.